Howdy, I'm Cole Cieslewicz. I am a freshman engineer at Texas A&M University, and this year I live in Hobby Hall, which is a modular style dorm on Northside. It's been great so far. I've been really happy with it. But during my research, there were a few things that I couldn't really find online, a few pieces of information that I didn't get from anyone else, and a few things that I just kind of wish I had known. So this is a video of me kind of giving a tour, showing some of those specific things about the dorm. If you have any questions at the end of the video, put them in the comments and I'll be sure to answer them as best I can, especially if it's during the spring of 2022, because I'll still be in the dorm then. So I can answer questions about things like measurements or specific things like that. So I hope this video doesn't get too long. I tried not to load it with a lot of the boring stuff that you can find anywhere else on the A&M websites, which I will link below for all the dorm specific information. So without further ado, I hope you enjoy the video. All right, so when you walk in, this is what you'll see. Closets are on my right, bathroom here on the left. Pretty easy layout. Now, as I walk into the dorm, you'll notice it is a little bit spacious for a dorm. This is actually the largest dorm you can get on campus. If you're living on campus, not in an apartment, this is the largest you can get. There are long sides and short sides to these modular dorms. Each one is different. Some dorms there it's the odd number, some dorms it's the even numbers. You'll have to look online to find out. It is noticeable difference though, so if you can, try to get the long side. I'm on the hobby, all odd side, so it is longer. As we go up to the bathroom here, I'll start by talking about these closets. So there are four closets in total. Two of them are at the front, two of them at the back. I'm using these as a pantry for storage on the one side, and then drinks up top. It works pretty great. So it's been working pretty great for me throughout the year. And on this side, I have it for storage for cleaning stuff. There is a partition wall in between these two sides. And there is not a partition wall on the ones at the back over there. No partition wall over here. Coming into the bathroom, there is a full length mirror in the dorm. It is pretty nice. I was thinking I'd have to get one. Not that I really need one, but it's here if you need it. There is a shelf on the mirror at the sink, pretty handy. The sink itself is a little bit small. You're not gonna be able to fit a full water bottle down there, so I would recommend getting some kind of Brita or relying on the water fill station out in the hall, because you're probably not gonna be able to fit a full-size water fountain in there. It is a little barren right now since I'm packing up to leave, but it works pretty well usually. Under the cabinets, there is almost 24 inches of space, but not quite. So what I did is I got some 24-inch kind of storage bins from Target, and I took the top part and placed it down here for each of them. And it works great like that. I took the top part off and I have no problems. Coming into the bathroom, this door is not high enough to clear a rug. So a thin rug like this even would not fit under this door. It is very low to the ground. It will fit under one of those. That one is high enough. Will not fit under one of these. So if you plan on getting a rug, just keep that in mind. And also this kind of rack thing that I had over the toilet, there's not a lot of storage. There's obviously no storage in here, no cabinets or anything. So I would recommend getting one of these if you want to, you know, put your clothes in here after a shower or anything like that. Put your phone on there. The toilet seat, you cannot put a lid on it. I was researching, we took it off, we tried, you cannot put a lid on it. There are two racks in each bathroom, and there is one hook on the back of this door right here. Not on the front, we have our own at the front. Inside the shower, plenty of space. I recommend getting a shower extension. This thing is really low, especially, I'm about 6'2", so it's, even with the shower extension, it's a little low, so I recommend that. There is a hook on the shower, and yep, that's what the shower looks like. It's fine as far as space goes, but what I can say is the water pressure is great and the heat is great. It is hot, pressurized water, so I'm very thankful for that. Coming out here, I'm gonna talk about the AC next. So the AC is right here. This unit does not have a heat cool setting. I think it's a little weird. It just has an up and a down. So you can set it wherever you want, but it will turn on heat and cool as it deems necessary to get it to that temperature. So there is no heat cool control. The fan control is manual. We just leave it on low all the time. It works great, keeps the air flowing, doesn't get stale in here. I would recommend that as well. And the only other reason I recommend keeping it on low is because this is the inlet right here. And the outlet is right here in the bathroom. So this is your vent. You don't have a manual switch vent like you do in most bathrooms. The vent, quote unquote, is the air being pushed into the bathroom, pushed out. So it actually works pretty well as far as, you know, keeping, you know, whatever you need out of the bathroom as far as bad smells goes. In the room itself, so you'll notice we have it set up here where we have two beds on one side and two desks on the other. This is called the desk. This is a bookshelf, and this is a pedestal. So I have a desk, bookshelf, and the smaller bookshelf on top in my pedestal. This is a great setup. I really like it. It's been working well for both of us. There is plenty of space, especially in these longer ones, for storage. These chairs are included that you see here. They're fine. They're not great though, so we each brought our own desk chairs, me and my roommate. And it's been working well for us so far. We have our beds lofted enough so we can have storage under it, but not so high that we don't have to climb up into it. And I really enjoyed that so far. I have my dresser under my bed, and he has it acting as his nightstand, which I think is really handy. Unfortunately, I did not get that side of the room. So yeah, he has it acting as a nightstand. My nightstand is this kind of little lamp thing I got with some shelves on it. I really recommend getting something like this because it is small and compact, but it does the job. You knock into it occasionally coming back here, but you get used to it. So I would get something like that if you have this side of the room. Over here is the micro chill. This is the one that A&M provides. They'll take in and out of your room for you if you pay a fee. I do recommend it. Microwave is a little bit weak and stuff will freeze the very back of the fridge occasionally, but I still recommend it. Also, what I recommend is getting some kind of light like this. This fluorescent light up here, it's bright, but it's not that bright. So I would recommend getting something else, especially some kind of warmer LED bulbs, a soft white bulb, to kind of brighten the room a little bit. It really does help a lot. Continuing over back here, these are the closets at the rear. We each use those for actual clothes. Again, there's not too many here just because I'm about to leave, but they slide, continues on the other side here. I recommend getting a few of these kind of light things to light up because in the dark, it is dark. So there's no light in here. So I recommend getting a few of those little light puck things. Over here by the curtain, by the window, the curtain is not provided. The blinds are provided. The blinds work fine. The curtains, they have this kind of like curtain rack thing here with little hooks on it so you can hang the curtain. It works really well. We were surprised to find this when we got here. So these are 96 inch curtains and they don't quite reach the bottom, but they reach the bottom enough to block out the light that we need. Yeah. So another thing, the walls, they're kind of rough. So command hooks, they'll stick. I have some on the wall, you see, but they're definitely not going to hold more than their advertised weight. So opt for larger if you can. I don't recommend putting tons of things on the walls, but obviously we've got stuff to hold on the wall. We got a whiteboard to hold on the wall with probably a dozen of those large command Velcro strips, which, by the way, love the whiteboard. If you have something like this handy, I would totally recommend it. Now, don't go out and buy one. It's not really that necessary, but it is really handy if you have it. We had it lying around, so I've enjoyed using it so far. Another thing is that it does get very dusty in here. The room does stay pretty, like, it gets pretty dusty. I just swept yesterday, and I picked up a surprising amount of stuff, even just from 1 week of use of the dorm. So make sure that you have some kind of broom to sweep up stuff, some kind of, you know, mop type thing. I've just got one of the cheap manual Swiffer wet things. It works great. I Swiffer every few weeks. Keeps it clean in here. I would definitely recommend something like that. If you have some kind of duster, bring that too for, you know, higher to reach places where dust will accumulate. Cleaning does come once a week, but it does smell pretty terrible. So for the first few hours that it's in here. So if you are a sucker for good smells, that is not one of them that you'll be able to enjoy. I'm just looking at my list here for a few more things. A desk light like mine keeps stuff organized. This is just a cheap kind of monitor light that I got on Amazon. It works great. It only points the light down. I fully recommend it. Storage under the bed. So like I said earlier, I recommend bringing a few of these storage bins to keep under your bed, just for miscellaneous things. Like where else would I put these coasters if I didn't have a random place for it? You just need a place for some random things. This works, this does the job. I would recommend bringing some kind of shoe rack. I don't have a ton there, because again, I'm leaving, but I have used it plenty of times. Some kind of hat rack. I actually still have the paper on this one, but that's where I put my hats. Additionally, bring some kind of lock for these this cabinet. So if you want, this cabinet will close like this, and if you put a lock right here in between, it will not open. So I actually don't have one. I probably will go get one. But it, if you have valuables that you want to keep safe, even safer than if you lock the door, that is a good way to do it. Most of the other things that you want to know about this dorm can be found online. I did tons of research before picking a dorm, and I chose Hobby Hall. But any of the modulars, I'm sure, will be fairly similar to this. So, yeah, I think that's about it.